Oh, and also side boost.
Sorry.
Ladies and gentlemen, mesdames, messieurs, mademoiselles, good afternoon and welcome to St. Bart. My name is Diana Burrell, and I have the honor of officiating the wedding ceremony for Julia and Zach. It's a real pleasure to be with you today. In 2015, at about the same time that Julia and Zach were discovering the existence of one another, Dean Brian Baker went to Burning Man for the first time. The blessing he gifted to participants that year has since made its way around the world. I'd like to share it with you today. He said, "The world now is too dangerous and too beautiful for anything but love. Love is a blessing. So may your eyes be so blessed that you see God in everyone. Your lips, so you speak nothing but the truth. Your ears, so that you hear the cry of the poor. May your hands be so blessed that everything you touch becomes a sacrament. Your feet, so that you run to those who need you. And may your heart be so opened, so set on fire, that your love, changes everything." Those last two lines, "And may your heart be so opened and so set on fire that your love changes everything," make for a particularly powerful statement on a day like today, where two individuals, ignited by a shared culture of value and meaning, are ready to make the world a better place. Zach and Julia have dreamed of this moment, and I believe, when talking to them, that they were certain, almost from the beginning, that this day would come. I think that if you're in the audience today, you can sense that Julia and Zach are lifers, in the same way that many of you are lifers. Some of you have known Zach since he was 5. Some of you have known Julia for just as long. Part of how you, as an entire community, make the world a better place is by sticking with each other. And Zach and Julia illustrate that point perfectly. They met during high school, just after Zach had changed schools. Soon afterwards, Julia and her family headed cross country. During the period of transition that is college and university, where couples meet, come together, and as often and as suddenly grow apart, they decided to commit to what they knew about themselves and about each other. So Zach went cross country too. And if you've ever taken a bold leap of faith, you know it's not your head driving the action, it's your heart. In very real ways, Julia and Zach have grown up together, become adults together, gone out into the world together. Throughout that time and all of the transitions it implied, they have continuously gained and provided themselves and each other with new visions and resources. They complement each other with their respective skill sets, strengths, and ideas. They encourage each other deeply and respect each other, both in their differences and in their similarities. And they've concocted their own recipe for successful relationship to self, to one another, to family, and to the world. Here are their ingredients: accountability, authenticity, transparency, honest communication, curiosity, the ability to lean in and be fully present, to care deeply, and to respect fully. Family has been a powerful container for them to explore life together. And while that link is ever in place, solid and gloriously dependable, they have branched off to create a parallel path that leads them inwards and towards one another. They are home to one another and to their dogs. In opening their hearts to one another, part of what they offer each other is called the compelling why. By that, I mean that deep underlying motive that drives action and behavior. Through their love for one another, each offers the other someone to do it for and someone to share it with. There is a sense of unbridled, incandescent, boundless joy and gratitude when you find this experience of sharing life with another human being. And although our human need for connection is universal, it's not just any human being. It's about finding that special person, your special someone, walking the path you were meant to walk, and finding the hand that belongs in yours. As one generation bequeaths the blessings and wisdoms to the next at moments like these, the visions and values held most dear by one generation are successfully passed on. Kind of like the Olympic flame, the culture of caring and love continues. When we think about models and mentors, or recall our ancestors and those who have walked before us, legacy is not so much a thing as it is a teaching. It's an example, a way of life. It's also the permission not to mimic the past, but to use our sovereignty to become the fullest expression of ourselves. And Zach and Julia are both very good at PDAs, which is not only about displaying affection, but also authenticity. The legacy of love is a tradition. It's a ritual and a practice that goes way beyond I love you. It's the why and how I love you, the every day and through time I love you. For Julia and Zach, it is knowing that to love another human being, full throttle, all in, you have to be able to show that kindness to yourself. And they do. It takes discipline. It takes daily practice to create the legacy of love. By practicing it, we transform ourselves and turn lead into gold. Alchemy is not just the raw ingredients. It's also the fire that transforms it, like in Dean Brian Baker's blessing. So how do you set your heart on fire? The alchemy occurs by being loved so deeply, and in turn, by loving so deeply that we really do change the world, because we change ourselves. So today, on this beach, St. Bart, remember one thing. This ceremony and all the steps it took to get here and all the steps that will come after the vows and the kiss is a dream come true for these two. It is a dream come true for them to be surrounded by all of you, the people they love the most in the world, all gathered here together in this circle of love. May this dream continue to grow and flower for all of the days of your lives. I'd like to invite Elise Anderson to come up and say a few words.
May you have the love that only you two can know. May you go where only two as one may go. May the sun rise and set in your bonded hearts, and the moon never find you too long apart. May you cherish each other's dreams as your own, and turn stumbling blocks into stepping stones. May you brave life's mountains and miles together. May there be no storm your love cannot weather. May you always be lovers and allies and friends. May your soul's conversations never end. May you capture on earth what's in heaven above. May your hearts know the rapture of an uncommon love.
Mm. Thank you. Zach and Julia, you tell each other how you love each other every day of your lives. But this time you're sharing your love in a really public way. And I'd like to invite you to express what you have to say for each other from the heart to your partners so that your family and friends may bear witness to the love that you now pronounce.
You can take over first.
I can hold it for you.
Zach. Every day I get the privilege of being loved by you. Some people go their whole lives trying to find the one person. And I'm so blessed that we got to find each other when we were 16 and 18. We have truly gotten to grow together in the best way. And you help me continuously grow into the person that I am and the best version of myself. There isn't a moment that I can't go to you with it, that I can't go to you without, with anything. Whether that is helping me with a big decision or just getting boop off from outside because he doesn't listen to me. From the way you take care of the chickens to anything around the house, your acts of service never go unnoticed. I'm beyond grateful for you and who you are. Something I always say to others is, who's the number one person you go to when you have news to share? And you will always be my number one. It's been 8 years since we started our lifelong journey together, and I couldn't ask for anyone better. You're the most caring, intelligent, and thoughtful person. It's always the little things in a relationship that keeps it flourishing. Like when we get each other little coffees when we're out, or bringing little things home to show we're always thinking about each other. This life is meant for us to live together, and I would have it no other way. This is the love people wish for and dream about, and I'm honored to be living this life with you. I'm proud to be your wifey. I love you.
That's beautiful.
Zach, I'd like to invite you to share your vows to Julia.
In this moment, this beautiful moment with you, I wanted to take just a brief moment to look around and feel the love and support that we have felt every day of our relationship. To take a moment to honor and cherish those that sit here today to celebrate us. Each of them, an important piece of each or both of our lives, each of them played a part in shaping the people we are today. Oh, I'd like to take a moment, look around. Now, if I'm somehow not crying, I would like to share a short poem that resonated with me during the writing process. I like to colloquially call it love. It didn't have a name. Love. Love is a mere word when placed next to what I feel for you. It's like calling the ocean a puddle or the sky a patch of blue. Love implies limits, boundaries where the heart can go. But what I feel for you flows beyond horizons to places love itself doesn't know. When you question my love, you question the very essence of who I am. Like asking the sun if it ever doubts its own light, or the shore if it questions the kiss of the tide. It's not a question of if I love you, but rather how could I not? Every beat of my heart sings your name, and every thought in my mind circles back to you. So do I love you? My goose, I exist in a perpetual state of loving you, as natural and as ceaseless as the air I breathe. And yet, the poem's over at this point. And yet, love is still the single strongest word we have to describe us. I love how you live every moment to the fullest. I love how selflessly you treat those around you. I love how you love our chickens. You are the first person I think of in the morning and the last I think of before I go to bed. You are the light of my life. I cannot wait to continue to learn about you every day. I cannot wait to see where the adventurous and windy road of life takes us both, because I know for absolute certainty that I will enjoy every moment more with you. I cannot wait to see how our morning coffee or our evening glass of wine evolves over the years. I cannot wait to love you more every day, to be able to know you, love you, and have the opportunity to grow old with you is a privilege that I do not take lightly. So, is love too small of a word for what I feel for you? I suppose we have the rest of our lives to find out. I'm shaking so bad.
Hell yeah. Zach and Julia, are you ready to take your wedding vows?
Yes.
Yes, of course. Oh,
God. Do you, Zach, take Julia to be your lawfully wedded wife, promising to love and cherish her, to protect and honor her through joy and sorrow, laughter and tears, sickness and health, and whatever challenges and triumphs you may face, for as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Will you love her for everything she is and everything she can yet become?
Yes, I will.
Do you, Julia, take Zach to be your lawfully wedded husband, promising to love and cherish him, to protect and honor him through joy and sorrow, laughter and tears, sickness and health, and whatever challenges and triumphs you may face, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Will you love him for everything he is and everything he can yet become?
I do.
Yeah. It won't work.
Elise, will you bring the rings? Thank you. Rings are an external symbol of an internal pledge to love, honor, and grow together through your love for one another. The circle represents a space where a million little points come together to create an unbroken promise without beginning or end.
Looks so pretty.
Yeah.
Julia and Zach, you have shared your vows and shown your commitment to each other in this moment of celebration. You've given and received rings, which are the symbol of the vows given here today, circles of wholeness, a symbol of never-ending love. Before we end, I'd like to invite some of your guests to share the blessings. For the first blessing on love, I'd like to invite Dawn and Robin, Julia and Zach's mothers. Will you come up? So you're going to read the first sentence? Yeah, and then Robin will read the second sentence. Start with right here.
Mm-hmm. Love. May you be blessed with love. May your admiration, appreciation, and understanding of each other foster a love that is passionate, tranquil, and real.
May this love between you be strong and endearing and bring peace into your lives.
Thank you so much.
To bless your home, I'd like to invite Sarah and Daniel.
I can't read, so.
May you be blessed with a loving home filled with warmth, humor, and compassion. May you create a family together that honors traditions, old and new.
May you teach your children to have equal respect for themselves and others and instill in them the value of learning and making the world a better place.
Thank you. To bless humor and play, and to remind you about all of the important moments between you and with the rest of the world, I'd like to invite Chaz, Tyler, and Joey to come up. So you'll each read a sentence.
Stand down there and be a normal height. Right? I know, right here. I can see
right here.
May you be best friends, work together to build a relationship of substance and quality.
May your sense of humor and playful spirit continue to enliven your relationship.
May you respect each other's individual personality and perspective and give each other room to grow in fulfilling your dreams.
Thank you.
To bless wisdom, I invite Scott to bless the transmutation of experience into wisdom.
May you be blessed with wisdom. May you continually learn from one another and from the world. Together, may you grow, deepening your knowledge and understanding of each other and of your journey through life.
Charleston will bless your health.
Are you a doctor?
I am not. I can act like I am.
May you be blessed with health. May life bring you wholeness of mind, body, and spirit. May you keep each other well-balanced and grounded and live a life that you may share many happy years together.
Thank you. Art, beauty, and creativity are an important part of life. Lou, will you please bring share the blessing?
May your life be blessed with the art and beauty of this world. May your creative aspirations and experiences find expression, inspire you, and bring you joy and fulfillment. May you find happiness together in adventures big and small, and something to celebrate each day of your lives.
And community. Nora, will you please come bless this couple with companionship and a sense of tribe?
May you be blessed with community. May you always be blessed with the awareness that you're an essential part of a circle of family and friends. May there always be within this group love, trust, support, and laughter, and may there always be future occasions for rejoicing in their company.
Thank you. Julia and Zach, be then blessed in every way. So we're coming to the end, and having completed all the passages of the sacrament of matrimony, it is my deep pleasure and honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Julia and Zach Hale. Zach, you may kiss the bride.
Ready?
Yep.
Okay, here we go. Yes?
Yep.
Hell
yeah!
Hell
yeah!
Hell yeah! Hell yeah! Okay, ready?
Get it, girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.